Do you recall what happened when the Germans occupied Paris? Do you recall any of that?
Oh, yes, when they occupied Paris, you know, they, first of all, the guard, the highways and everything was with guard. We cannot go through with the car. We have to go through a guard, very just the size from the car or the bicycle, and they ask you for sometimes for your papers and everything, and start to get bad, you know. In the beginning, they don't touch the Jews, but we can see they start to look for Jews, and it start to get very hard for food and everything. Everything start to get restricted, and start to get bad in Paris.
Were you aware of the Jewish laws that had been passed at that time? Did you see the star,
you mean? I never wore the star. It's not a question I was ashamed, but I need a job. And a Jew cannot have a job in public. He cannot have a job in a factory. He can have no place. But we have to survive. And I know my parents need money to survive. It was very hard at the time. The two brothers was in the army. And that's been, I was working, go to work in a factory. I don't tell them I'm Jewish, and they gave me the job. But my name, I passed through, and I got the job. Every morning, I was going to work with the train, took the train in the morning, very early. That's been the German, at that time, they don't shake. And I come back late in the night. And I was always lucky not to get caught. When you get caught, you know, they port you right away when you don't want the star. And it was a very hard time, you know. When I was going to work in the morning, we got a designer from the factory, and we got a manager from the factory, always talking about Jews. But he say, one day he say, I don't like the Jews, something happened in my building. They come the last night with the French police and the German police, and they pick up all the Jewish families. And for one woman, when they separate the woman from the children, she opened the window and she killed herself. She jumped out. Alors, what did you say? And when I heard that, I started to tell myself, I started to get bad. It's been 2 weeks later, we discussed the family, what are you going to do? France was divided, was a free zone, and the occupied zone. And we decided we're going to have to go to the free zone. And we need money to pay a guy to bring it to the free zone. And I went back to the factory and I told him I need the money. He said, you cannot get the money, he said to me, in the middle of the week. He said, you have to come Friday. I said, I need the money. He said, why? I said, I'm Jewish. When you heard I'm Jewish, he started to get crazy. You know, I'd be in trouble. He said, come back tomorrow. Tomorrow, my father said, don't go back, they're going to arrest you. And we need the man back in the morning by 5 o'clock. I wait till 9 o'clock. They call me in the office and he say, you wait here. That's my wait. I say, I got the fray. They came back with my pay. He said, you know what? We like you very much in the factory. I made a collection for you. You get a double pay. I gave me the money. And he said to me, in case you want to go to the free zone, he say, I can take you over there immediately. Tonight, I put you with the conductor from the locomotive, I dress you up like a working man, and you can go. I said, no, I got my family, I can do that. I got my father, my mother, my sister, I cannot leave them. He said, no, I can do that for you. I go back home, ask your father. And I come back, my father said, yeah, you have to go. I said, no, I'm not going to go, we stay together. And we got the money. And we got somebody, an inspector from the police, coming by us. He wants so much money. We don't have so much money. I said, do you have silver, do you have gold, we have some valuable things. He said, he gave me everything. He took everything from us. He said, I'm going to bring you to the free zone. Not in the free zone, you have to wait to the border, and after that, we pass you to the free zone.